Let's open the Bible.
Are you reaching Lamudim?
John 21.
John 21, Johannes 21.
From verse 15 to 19.
John 21, 15 to 19.
Thank you, Jesus. I said what? From what? 15 to
21.
We'll read from verse what? 15.
Verse 15.
Are you there?
Amen.
So when they had denied, Jesus said, when they have dined, Jesus said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me more than this? And he says unto him, yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. And he said unto him, feed my lambs.
Heba fediche ufitlula Jesu abolela li Simon Petro ari. Simon morwa Jona uyamtata ufitisha ba. Petro ari emre na utiba ubani kia urata. Jesu ari fudisha di kwanyana jaka.
He says unto him the third time, Simon son of Jonah. And then he said, lovest thou me? Peter was grieved because he said unto him the third time, lovest thou me? And he said unto him, Lord, thou knowest all things. Thou knowest that I love thee. Jesus said unto him, feed my sheep.
Abuela amuchisha labubedi are. Simone morwa Jona auyantata. Petro ari emrena utsiba gubane kia urata. Jesu ari disha unkuchaka.
18. Verily, verily, I say unto thee, when thou was young, thou gathered thyself, and walkest whither thou wouldest. But when thou shalt be old, thou shalt stretch forth thy hand, and another shall get thee, and carry thee whither thou wouldest not.
Rore, rore, kia hubuja, 18. Mola usalie muswa ube uite mama teka kanoshi, waikela mo ube uurata, itori re utufechi utonta. Matsogo a gago mme wa tlengwa ke mongwe a go isha mo sa go ratego.
This spake he, signifying by what death he should glorify God. And when he had spoken this, he saith unto him, follow me.
Ge a rielo e be e le go moswantšhetša le go le yena Petro a tlo o godiša modimo ka lona ge a itjalo a re ntatele.
Let's pray. Father, we thank you for your word in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Today, let's talk about relationship.
Because
where we have read there, we found Jesus is asking relationship. If you say, do you love me? You are asking, are you sure? You are standing with me. Peter answers several times.
Petro afetula
hanchi. I love you. But when Jesus asked for the third time,
maraha Jesu yo buchisha laburaru.
Peter realized that this is serious.
Petro alemora tabaye yonai serious.
You know all things. Are
morena utsiba dilo cheka moka.
Why Peter said, Lord, you know all things?
Why aiche morena utsiba dilo kamoka?
Remember that Peter denied
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He denied Jesus.
Uila gana Jesus.
And Jesus said, you are going to deny me.
Jesus na muri charwe na utongana.
So here it was like Jesus was turning back the cassette also to cancel the past.
Mo kare Jesus na bujeta cassette murao rapumulejela chakopile.
But now when Jesus end up saying yes, I see that you love me.
He said,
let me give you responsibility.
There
is no relationship without responsibility. If you can read there, you'll realize that Jesus end up talking about the growth of Peter.
O tla lemoa Jesu a feletse a bolela ka o gola ga Petro.
He said, Peter, when you were small.
Are Petro na go tshela o sa le monnyane.
When wind comes carries you.
Na ha o tla moya o tla no no rwala.
It means there was no relationship.
O ra re ne o sina segotso ba swalle.
But when relationship is strong, when you're old.
Ha re setswalle se tile o ra re jwa no godile.
You can do anything to keep up the relationship.
O ka dia dilo tsheka o fela a tsona o diele re segwana so sieme.
That's why Jesus said.
Ke ka le baka le o Jesu a itse.
He was saying this signifying how he will die.
Na a mutsa se a mo le mosha ka mogo atla gwao.
In other words.
Ka mantjo a mangwe.
Peter could lose his life for relationship.
Petro a ka lathelwa ke bophelo jwa gae ka le baka la segotse.
He doesn't want to lose relationship.
Aya ko lathelwa ke segotse.
Whether somebody can kill him for this relationship.
Mothemwa ka mulai wa mulai ka le baka la segotse se.
He was ready.
Na e ke mishedi tse seo.
That's my friend.
Go tsone ga furu mogotse.
There is a relationship.
Ona le segotse.
That you need to maintain.
Go ba segwera se tshwentse dira re sieme.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus died for you.
Jesu a isho ufetse
relationship.
O diela re be le segotse.
Many of us, we don't understand why relationship.
Ba bantsha re kwishishi re why go tshwentse ba le segwera.
We were far away.
Ne re le kwa gole kwa.
By his death we were brought close.
Ka le gola ga e ra buswa ra tswa ga uswe.
We were not his people.
Ne re se batho ba hae.
By his death we are his people.
Ka le gola ga e jono re batho ba hae.
We were in the darkness.
Ne re le ko leswiswing.
But we have been transferred to the kingdom of God.
Mara re go botswe ra tsenya ka rammoso wa sietsa.
Therefore we can see him clear.
Shono re mona botse.
Because we are in the kingdom of his light.
Ka o bana re ka rammoso wa sietsa.
Where there is light.
Mo o neng sietsa.
There is no secret.
A ona makunuto.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number 2.
Sabubedi.
Where there is relationship.
Mo o nang le segotse.
Just read this verse I will share give you.
Are ba leng verse e.
Where there is relationship.
Mo go na le segwetse.
John 15 verse 15.
John 15 15.
John 15 15.
Johanne 15 verse 15.
You are called friends.
Re bitswa ba gotse go ba bagwera.
You are no longer called servants.
Are sa bitswa ba shumi go ba bereke.
Where there is relationship, there is togetherness.
Mo go nang segotse go na le botee.
You are called friends.
Re bitswa ba gwera.
No longer servants.
Are sa le ba hlanka.
Can I read that verse for you?
Ere ke le baleng yona.
Henceforth I call you not servants, for the servants knoweth not what his lord doeth, but I have called you friends, for all things that I have heard of my father I have made known unto you.
Ha ke re le ba hlanka. Gobane motlhanka ga tsebe se mongwa gagwe a se dirago lena ke re le bagwera ka gobane ke le bodise tsotlhe tse ke di kwilego ka tate.
You are friends.
Lena le bagwera.
No secret.
Ha ona makunutu.
When God wants to do something,
ha modimo a nyaka go dira ntwa e tseo,
it does not happen per accident.
A e dirale ka kotsi.
He will tell you.
O tla le botsa.
Are you hearing that?
Le antwa.
If things just happen,
ha di ntodi no thalela fela fela,
and without being informed,
uri sa butjo ba sa bolelelwa,
our relationship is shaken.
Si khotse sa rena sa hema.
You know, I want to tell you more about relationship.
Ere ke le mocheng ka ka o fitisha ka boera.
I found that the more you build your relationship,
ke thotse ha wena o ka aga segwera se
with Jesus.
Le Jesu,
there is a harmony of that relationship.
O go ba le utsama ya botsi ya segwera se.
There's something that relationship produces.
Bona le ntwe e segwara se se ta yenywago.
That bring communication.
Se se ti shang puledishano.
Are you hearing me?
Le ankwa.
You cannot make friend anywhere else we don't talk together.
O ka se be le mogotso o sa boleleng le yena.
Here the Bible says.
Mo ke Bible ire.
Now that you are no longer my servant.
Ja no ka le bakala ra le sa le bahlanka.
Because we are in relationship.
Ka le bakala ra mo segwereng.
So whatever I do I make known to you.
Ka mo ka tsena ke di diang ke di tsebisa tsona.
It means there is no secret.
Wo ra ra o sana makunutu.
If you are sick.
Halelwala.
You must know why you are sick.
Le tsotso tsebo re why le lwala.
You got a friend there.
Le na le mogotse.
Are you hearing me?
Hallelujah.
That's my friend.
Gwatango le gafile re bogotse.
When you are blocked.
Ha wena o tswaleletse.
You must know why you are blocked.
Tsi bo re wa o tswaleletse.
Because there's a friend.
Ka ba nna le mogwera ga o file wena.
And the same Jesus,
and I just saw you now.
He said he will never leave you for forsake you. I will be with you until to the end. He's a friend forever. Friend when friends are gone. Friend when people are rejecting. Friend when people are fighting you. He's your friend. He's on your side. And he will never leave you. And he will never forsake you. He's your friend. Test us,
hey.
I have somebody you cannot see. When we have friends like
Jesus,
some friends can leave us. Some situation can go down. But that doesn't mean it's over. Are you hearing me? You remember
Gehazi
with Elisha?
Elisa.
When they were together, when they were soldiers camping around them.
How no limashola but
you remember that time? And the Bible says Elisha prayed.
Elisa rapela.
Because Gehazi
Kauri Gehazi
could not see the enemy. Sometimes we are so occupied here by our situation that we cannot see beyond our situation. And this is affecting our relationship. You tend to say, oh God, if you're around, you were supposed to have solved this. You speak like Martha and
Maria.
If you were around, our brother was not supposed to be there. And you find that Jesus could still say, let's go, our friend Lazarus is asleep. If you read there, in John 11 there, and you read there, verse 11 there, you'll find Jesus say, let's go, our friend Lazarus is asleep. You know, the moment Jesus called you a friend, there's a miracle.
That's
our friend. The moment Jesus called you a friend, there is a miracle. You see now, people were saying, look how he cried. He loved him so much. Jesus cannot just love you for nothing. Let's go back to the case. If really your friendship does not bring forth communication, you are doomed. That's not friendship
there.
If you have got a friend that you work with and you don't talk together,
that's a problem.
In other words, somebody's not trusting another. Or there might be a boundary between two friends. When this one is speaking, that one cannot hear. The problem we have today is our relationship is not strong with the Lord. And this has affected our communication with him. We don't know now. We don't know what to do now. I was reading about
Balaam.
I found people that say he was a witch. He was not.
Balaam
was a prophet that speaks a word that happened. So the problem of
Balaam
is when Balak goes to him. Are you hearing me? So now, the Bible says, when Balak came there, he came with noble people and gifts. So now, that's where the communication was broken. Friendship diminished. Are you hearing me? Because the Bible says, he was told by God, don't go with them. But he just went there. Look what happened on the road. The donkey was climbing. Saw an angel. And therefore the donkey was able to communicate with the angel. But look at the prophet though. Many prophets today cannot hear, listen. What is affecting the church is hearing from God. We are talking too much,
but
we are hearing zero. The problem is our relationship.
Amen.
The moment I lay hands here and people fall down, it means God is talking. No. No. It might be a dangerous mission.
E ka ba ile mushiro o mukotse.
Tell my friends.
Wo cha mutshwana ka from khosi.
The moment I lay hands.
Ka na ko yekile biya matso.
And people are falling.
Ene ba tshwa bango ba iwa.
That does mean that God is talking.
A ra muthimu wa bulela.
Are you hearing me?
Le antwana.
Are you hearing me?
Le antwa.
The moment you are blessed with what you desire.
Kana ko yele na li shufa tswa ka tumo ya pelo.
That does mean that God is talking.
A ra muthimu buletse ba wa bulela.
Many of us now,
we value God that
He speaks
because
of what we
have. We can
still go with those
things to have. If
we establish our
relationship,
we will know the right
blessing and the wrong blessing.
We won't worry
about
material benefits. We will understand that any situation
is
for the glory of God. Are you hearing
me?
Tell us, my friend. I'm feeling that I must establish my relationship. If really, listen. If you want God to use you, don't cry for anointing. Establish relationship. It's not what you do.
I didn't touch
when you pray or you fast, that brings anointing. Is the relationship you are creating. When you stay close to
how
him, are you hearing me? You listen, you do. You listen, you do. As you are carrying on, that relationship
you establish.
I read the Bible, I found that Abraham established relationship.
Abraham oiladi asikhotsi sa ile modimo.
Noah established relationship. Though it was like that, people were laughing. In the time of Noah. In the time of Abraham. God said, leave the people of your family. He listened, he did. Establish relationship.
Amen.
Tell
my friends.
Are you establishing relationships? You can still come to church. And you ask God, God use me. And you find God is not using you. What about relationships? If you read the Bible for other people, you can still kill yourself because your relationship with him is not there. That's my friend. Today, look at your life and him. Forget about other people. If you want God to use you, to bless you, to lift you, check yourself and God, not yourself with people. Tell
some
of my friends. Yourself with God.
Na
so when your relationship is stronger, so God will send you
somewhere.
I love, you know, I'll read the scripture, I'll tell you, but I love this man who went to Samaria. That man, he did spectaculars. Demons were screaming, shouting, but look what happened there. He knew that there are certain things that doesn't need him. Because if you do things that doesn't need you, you affect your relationship. If you do things that does not need you, you affect your relationship. Remember, relationship is based because of friendship. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So he said, no, this I cannot do.
So
are
you going to do it?
Though I'm seeing demons screaming, there are leaders at home. He called Peter,
Abija Petro,
James, they
Abija Jacob, Abata,
and they pray with people. They even found problems.
Okay.
Think about
Nahana,
that guy called
Simon.
If really this man tried to deal with the problem there. This Simon was supposed to have defeated it. There are certain things that need others. Be faithful on what you are hearing. Doing what you are hearing. Because by doing that, what you are hearing, you are establishing your relationship. Are you hearing that?
Hallelujah.
Can you see what happened? After that, the Holy Spirit took him. He found a man reading what he doesn't understand. We have got many people today who are busy with what they don't understand. Pray without understanding. Fasting without understanding. This man was reading the book of Isaiah, but he was not understanding. And the prophet was taken closer.
That's
what my friends. Today, a prophet has taken closer to you. Was taken closer. And from today, there will be victory upon your life. That relationship will be revived. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Christianity is not based on stories. Christianity is based on what? Relationship. I remember a long time ago, I used to see some people reading because they are going to preach. Fasting because they'll be preaching one way. We need Christians who establish their Christianity, whether they've got a task or not, they maintain that level. Whether you are sick or not, you maintain that level. I want to maintain my level. Look at this verse. If you read verse 13 there, in John 15 there,
and I'm on John 15.
Can you read it aloud in your Bible? It says,
lerato le le fetishago la yeo a ga fa go bophelo jwa gagwe ka bakala ba go ra bagagwe.
I see the verse.
Le bona verse.
Okay, 14.
14. Lena le ba go ra baka ge le dira tshe ke le laitse go tsona.
Pastor says,
botsholeng gaufi.
Do you think what you are doing is what you have been commanded? Ask somebody again. Usually, many of us, we don't even know. Are you hearing me? We don't even what? We are just Christians because we are coming to church. And our relationship is based on what we want. The day we get what we wanted is Jesus. We are going to talk about it. As Jesus has done it. You know what Jesus has done. I was telling some people that don't just come and stand here and talk what you're not sure. Are you hearing me? Because sometimes you find that the job you are getting is becoming a temptation to you. Did you hear that the job you are searching is the right one? Have you found yourself getting a job? After 3 months, you're crying about it.
Huh?
So therefore, any blessing can be a curse to you. We need to hear, but our hearing is based on our friendship with Him. Our relationship must be established. Are you hearing me? That's why, my friend, there are things that come to steal your relationship. Number one, temptations. Just write it down. Temptations are there to steal. When you see this, you say, oh, why?
How about that you're mulatto?
You pray, why are you mulatto? Sometimes you pray because you are facing this. So when you're no longer facing this,
so
how
subtle or copanalicho now?
Prayer is useless.
Sapeloya etenamohola.
Temptations
Miliko
can also drive us out
Egarincha
where God wants us to be.
Mopa apanya kang riba hona.
Because when you're sick now, your prayer will be directed
on this
financial crisis, on that line of finance. There is no day where you will fast to thank God. There is nobody who can start saying, you know what? I've been fasting. What kind of fasting? I want to fast for my salvation.
Thank
God for my salvation. Usually when you fast, I want to change this. But I want to see this. Therefore, temptation can even direct your prayer and direct you on what to pray. Whereas the Bible says, pray without ceasing. Number two, people you love most, write it down. People you love most, they can be used. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
To affect your relationship. Because you need to listen to them. You cannot just take decisions. You want to hear from them. And what about God? Now the family says, there's a gathering. We want to worship those idols. If you won't be there, it means you are cut off from the family. So you decided to go to that family. Why? Because you want to be part of that. You say, I won't eat there. But as long as you are there, you are part of them. We need Christians. Whether people love you or not, you hear from God. You hear from God. Tell some friends. Today, God will speak with you.
As I was saying,
when was the last time we heard God speak? Can you ask somebody? When was the last time we heard God speak? What do you say? Follow God. Which God?
Or ulatela modimo o mofi modimo ntse.
Which God you are not even hearing talking. You see, you hear God. Follow God. Which God? I'm a Christian. What kind of Christian is
that?
Who doesn't have communication with the one you are following?
Shano, mara walatela.
The reason is you are having people you listen. And you want to please them. But if you tell yourself, now I'm hearing I must fast. I must fast 3 days. They call you and say, hey, come and cook. You go and cook for them. You give them. Yeah. Why is like you're not eating?
I
have the food that I'm eating. Are you hearing me? You know, hearing from God, parents can even divert you from not hearing him. Because devils speak louder. When you are close to breakthrough, that's why I'm very close to you. Say, hey, devils speak louder. When you are close to breakthrough, can you tell the person again? Devil speak louder. When you are close to breakthrough. So, people will come, you laugh. People you cherish, they will come and say, why are you doing this? Are you stupid? Don't stop there fast. Don't do that. Don't go there. But tell yourself, I'm doing this because I've got a relationship with Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Today, when you are related to him, things will begin to happen. I said things will begin to happen. Listen. There were times me and mama, people were having in the church, they decided not to tithe.
But decided to tithe.
They sit down the church, they say,
don't support.
And then, you know, I spoke with mama. So kavulela le ma ona dijo ona sila. As a mama,
kare mawe.
We'll do our own stupid way.
Retla dira dilo tsa rena ka tsela ya rena ya botaela.
Whatever we have.
Ka moka tsa rena le tsona.
Cook for children.
Retla phela bana.
And by the time of eating.
Kana ko ya uja.
We'll go and sit on our own table.
Retla tsama ya rodula ko tafuleng. Amen.
And we put another chair there for the one who represents
us.
Holy Spirit was there. Are you hearing me? We sit there.
Mama is there.
Mama
wona.
Table was empty. And there was a chair there
for the Holy Spirit.
This, if you do it, people will mock you. Are you hearing me? The small food cooked for children. We sit there. We hold hands. Father, we thank you for food. We are about to eat. We thank you for this food. We sit there. And he said, hey, no, we are Canaan. We have eaten.
Rijile.
How do you feel, my
man? Ah, okay.
Okay, I'm okay. Okay, no, thank you. Holy Spirit, you saw that. This is the food you have given us. Can I tell you? Holy Spirit, you will never say, why these people are doing this?
Why batho ba ba dira dilo tse?
Holy Spirit will say, these people, they know I'm around.
Batho ba ba tse bo rena ke teng.
Though they cannot see me,
le ge ba sampone ka
matho, they know I'm around to bring this food. Ba tse bo
rena ke teng o tisha dijo.
That to see does it.
O fitisha o dula wa
re. I don't know.
A ke tsebe.
What I will eat.
Ke ta diang.
I don't know.
A ke tsebe.
What? Listen.
Tiele tsa.
Stop grumbling.
Tuela o ngongoreya.
You are not alone.
A o tsamaya o le teng.
That's all. Hey, stop.
Bo tsho le ga fr tuela.
Stop grumbling.
Tuela o ngongoreya.
If you ask my daughter,
with Bishop,
there was no car. So we began to believe in cars. Always we hear something like a truck.
My daughter
and Bishop will move out running. They say, hey, there's a truck coming. Bring our car. When they reach there, they find his truck passing. They say, that one has
carried
an old one. Let's carry useless car. We thought it's the one that is
carrying.
There is another one that is
carrying.
If you can see, because of relationship, beyond your situation, you will stop worrying and begin to trust the living God. And the living God will never leave you or forsake you. Your friends are leaving you. Thank God. Your family is talking. Thank God. They can speak what they are saying. But you need to stand up and say, hey, I have somebody bigger than
them.
The one who creates heaven and earth. I'm not alone. I'm not alone. I'm not alone. Thank God you were having a problem. Thank God for that problem. You know, sometimes when somebody claps you, thank God. You run to God. Sometimes you have got a pain. But why? That pain is telling
pain
you.
Are
you sure you are related to
Jesus?
Do you love me more than pain?
Pain?
Do you love me more than food? Do you love me more than a car? Do you love me more than a house? There are some people, if the house collapses, they will divorce.
But a divorce.
Because they won't even understand that divorce
is written that is called,
is abomination in the word of God. But when something wrong happens, divorce.
That's
my friend. Today, whether it's tough or not, I will establish my relationship. When you are carrying on, establish your relationship. You know what you are saying? What has happened doesn't touch you. What is coming is fit for you. When you are thanking God in time of crisis, you are saying this crisis is useless. What is coming is above this crisis. When you are thanking God, when you are sick, you are saying this sickness doesn't hurt you. The healing is coming. That will manifest in your body. Are you hearing me? Shake somebody and say, hey, I'm not afraid. So sometimes you face what you are facing. You're saying, yeah, fala.
You're saying, yeah, fala. I'm dead.
Like
I am dying.
Yeah, humble.
I'm going.
Yeah, humble.
You will never die. You will never die. I will never die.
Say that pain.
The pain you
will never kill me.
Simple.
You must go to that point. Whereby you establish relationship. Jesus died. I mean, he was scorched. He had some things here. The body was not recognized. But he rose from the dead. The same spirit that was in Jesus is in me. It will revitalize my body. If I look weak, I'm strong. That's a hey! When you look weak, you're strong. Can you hear what I'm telling you?
Now?
When somebody divorces you, very good. Congratulations. The person is telling you, I was not fit for you. And God will give you the best. When you get something like
that,
people are laughing at you. Very good. You must not divert from relationships. Stand there. And say they are laughing me. Because they are about to see what my God is about to do. Listen. Stop worrying anymore. See what God can do. Are you singing? If you are singing, you will rejoice. Because what you are singing is coming to you. In the name of Jesus. 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 Establish your relationship. There are times whereby, have you ever found yourself, you don't have a cent? You are hungry. And you don't know who's going to help you. And you find that you don't know that his eyes are on the faith. So when this thing is happening, it's like everything around you is laughing at you. But God is watching. He's speaking. He said, this one, I trust. This one will do what is right. This one will prove Satan wrong. Are you hearing me? Remember
Job.
Today, God will give you with double. He will give you double. I say he will give you double. Can I prophesy? This year. This year, this month of July. You will shine your shine. You will shine your shine. I say you will shine your shine. Think about when you overtake your enemy. Overtake your family. They are talking. Because God allowed it. But God is about to change their topic. Establish that friendship. Establish it. Whatever your face is asking you. Establish it. You can look poor, look weak, look out, but tell yourself, I will never leave Jesus. I will never leave what? I will leave what? I will leave
Satan
and follow Jesus. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready?
Amen.